punch out, every punch out.
The sorest every part of Daniel Sanchez's arms, his hands. Lerma standing still. That's a mistake. Closing seconds of the eighth. Another good finish. Another good message to the judges.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, how about one big more round of applause for our friends from MacDill Air Force Base and all our servicemen and women protecting our freedom around the world.
Throw it loose. If you want to throw your lead hook and then come back with your straight leg. You don't want to end up like you've been doing. But you've got to. You've got to stay on it, Mike. You've got to throw more than one shot.
Well, we've seen Earl Santos all the time. That's the beginning of the round. A five-punch combination in there with blinding speed on Lerma. And then at the end of the round, with Lerma positioned to score, Santos says, no, sir. Santos was cornered, and he does that.
Beginning seconds of round number nine. Daniel Santos defending his title in a most amazing way and dominating manner.
Don't push him. Don't push him. Daddy. Keep it clear. Don't push him.
There are performances in which you can win, and then there are definitive performances. And Santos has gotten to that level at this point tonight. This is the one that should get a lot of respect in the boxing community.
As impressive as his offense is, the way he has stayed away from Michael Lerma has been just as impressive.
That's the key to his longevity. One thing to be a nice offensive fighter. If you can do that without paying too much. And again, that's where the speed helps you on both sides. Defensive.
Step in.
A tricky question. That will step in the missing combination. The guy's just getting peppered, beaten, one and two punches at a time. They almost can step in.
Hand free, punch out. Let him go, Mike. Punch out, hand free.
In round number nine, more of the same from Santos and Lerma.
Thank you.
It's hard to feel good when you're getting drilled like this. Nice right hook by Santos, and Loma with a ton of heart. And you know, if Santos would come up with one 5 or 6 punch combination, that would be a good excuse for the referee to step in to save a fighter who is too game for his own good.
Well, I'm curious, if Lerma comes in with his own 5 or 6 punch combination, does that back Daniel Santos off? And we have not had that opportunity to see and answer that question.
There was one round of 5 where they both opened it up and scored simultaneously. It was quite a round. Lerma's been there and he's trying all the time. There's nothing you can do except fight your fight and hope something opens up.
Good lead. Good lead by Daniel Santos. Being warned by referee Max Parker Jr. not to push.
This is so clear cut. I mean, you can't go back and say, well, my conditioning wasn't there. It's not that. No injuries, no controversial calls. This is a guy performing at his best and just getting blown out.
Look at Michael Lerma on his toes still. The amount of punishment that he has taken, and still on his toes, still coming forward.
Guy that's been used to winning on the hot trail.
Good job, man.
But to keep it going, all you have to do is beat the champion. He got himself this far, which is excellent. And this is why Santos is ruling the roost. From Santos, Lerma comes in, 3-punch combination, comes back out, shows an angle, and just keeps putting good combinations together. Daniel Santos with an excellent right hook there, snapping the head back of Michael Lerma. Lerma has earned his money tonight.
Round number 11 for the WBO World Junior Middleweight Championship. Daniel Santos so far has proved he is indeed king. Whether he likes it or not, this performance is going to give Michael Lerma a lot more fight.
Because people will look and say, look, he ended up with a game fight, and he lost. So next week we'll see this guy comes to fight every night. He's also a good style to go against for whomever, because he comes straight up. So whatever style you have, Michael Lorman would bring a good fight into the arena.
And I think we cannot overemphasize how good a fighter Michael Lorman is. I mean, he does come in with 29 wins, 20 knockouts. So it's not like he's just a slouch going against the champion. This was just evidence of how much better Daniel Santos is than anyone else.
Lorman has performed as well as he can fight. Santos is that much better. It's an important distinction to make because some government good records have fraudulent good records. Lorman's a legitimate, but Santos is on another planet tonight.
Danny, go.
They have closed that cut on the left eye of Santos.
Both corners did a good job tonight. Lermas was in a dangerous spot. They closed it up.
Great, no question.
He cooperated by not getting hit there.
Minutes go in round number 11. Scheduled for 12. Santos looks like he could go 20 or 30 rounds at this pace.
And the heads come together. That's the only thing that would stop him from going 20 or 30 rounds. Nasty cut.
And they do stop the clock.
Go ahead.
Now, if this were to be stopped,
all right,
because of that,
you okay?
They would go to the scorecard.
Let me see. Okay, you all right?
Well, I'm going to go ahead.
Okay, you all right? All right.
Won't get to that level. Nasty collision.
Watch your hands, okay?
Right. You got two guys bending low, trying for leverage and getting punching room. They lean forward with the head. That's what happens.
20 seconds to go in this 11th round. Toughest blow that Santos took was here.
Let's journey into that danger zone. The heads come together. But fortunately, there was not a lot of forward motion first. It was from in tight. It's when the heads come together from far away that the heads open up. And this is vintage Santos. Even if he is slapping a little bit here, it's the first time we've really noticed that.
Some noise here.
Hey, he's only human. He's got to be getting tired.
Doesn't want to knock Lorman out. He's got respect for him now.
The 12th and final round of this WBO World Junior Middleweight Championship. Daniel Santos, the defending champion in the black trunks. Michael Lorman, the challenger in the white trunks. It has been all Daniel Santos and a very game Michael Lorman, who just will not go away, which means he still has punching power and he can still be dangerous. So far, he's not been able to catch a very active Daniel Santos.
Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. On the break, back it up.
Lorman again just doing everything he has, coming forward, trying to land one big shot.
Lorman
Santos all over.
Lorman will be at his most dangerous now in this 12th round.
He knows the finish is at hand. He can pour everything into 3 minutes. Santos continues to pop it. Really impressed. he's able to keep that up over a long fight like this. He has not noticeably slowed at all. And this bodes well for him in future matchups.
Now Santos back up against the ropes, giving Lama a shot. Daniel Santos has to be thrilled with his victory.
When you see matches like this, it's why boxing fans won't tolerate guys who don't give them action. It's out there, it's possible. More guys should fight like this. Well, here is Santos just continuing what he's been doing since round one. Putting on the pressure from any angle you want to look at it. All Santos all the time. An exemplary effort by the champion.
Michael Lerma finished off strong. Daniel Santos took everything that Lerma could throw at him. And there, a show of respect by each fighter for their opponent. Daniel Santos, the champion, fought unlike any other champion has fought. A tremendous defense of his title for Daniel Santos against a very strong, very game Michael Lerma, who has nothing to be ashamed of.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we announce the decision, how about one last round of applause for both of these fighters right here? Putting on one heck of a fight for you. All right, fight fans, here we go. We go to the scorecards, and here is your decision. Judge Valerie Dorsett scores this fight 118 to 110. Judge Michael Pernak and Judge Peter Tremetera both see it the same way at 120 to 107 for your winner by unanimous decision. And still the WBO junior middleweight champion of the world, Daniel Santos.
No surprise there, Daniel Santos with a successful defense of his WBO World Junior Middleweight crown. And a smiling Michael Lerma. He showed a lot of people that he is a very game fighter. He survived an onslaught. Santos, who threw his best at him and could not put Lerma away, but an overwhelming victory on two of the judges' cards. They had every round for Santos plus one. For my cohorts, Dave Bontempo, and our special guest, Mike Ramore, I'm Lon McCarron. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you next time. So long from Tampa.